Today's video is brought to you by the video sharing website, TV.com. That is spelled with two E's and three E's, TEEVEEE.com. A link to my channel over there is in the box. Check it on out to get access to some exclusive video content. How's everybody doing? My name is Anthony Brian Logan, and today we got to talk about Mark Zuckerberg, the head honcho over at Facebook, vowing to battle Pocahontas, aka Elizabeth Warren, if she were to become president. Now, there is a whole lot to quote unquote unpack here, as the cool kids would say. But first, let's get to the audio that was leaked from some internal Facebook meeting that you'll hear Mark Zuckerberg talking about this and a few other things. After we get done with that, I'll talk about what he said in the audio. I'll give you my analysis, give you my two cents, then I'll wrap it on up with a nice bow on top. So without further ado, let's go ahead and roll it.
Like Elizabeth Warren, who thinks that the right answer is to break up the companies, if she gets elected president, then I would bet that we will have a legal challenge, and I would bet that we will win the legal challenge. Does that still suck for us? Yeah, I mean, I don't have to, have a major lawsuit against our own government. I mean, that's not like the position that you want to be in when you're, it's like we care about our country and like want to work with our government to do good things. And but look, at the end of the day, if someone's going to try to threaten something that existential, you go to the mat and you fight. It's just that breaking up these companies, whether it's Facebook or Google or Amazon, is not actually going to solve the issues. And, it doesn't make election interference less likely. It makes it more likely, because now the companies can't coordinate and work together. That's why Twitter can't do as good of a job as we can. I mean, they face qualitatively the same types of issues, but they can't put in the investment. Our investment on safety is bigger than the whole revenue of their company. They literally cannot do it.
I'm not going to go to every single hearing around the world. A lot of different people want to do that. I mean, when the issues came up last year on Cambridge Analytica, I did hearings in the U.S. I did hearings in the EU. It just doesn't really make sense for me to go to hearings in every single country that wants to have me show up. And
okay, so you heard that. You see what's going on. Now, I'm not really sure where to begin. Let's start from the very top, to address what I think is the elephant in the room. Mark Zuckerberg does not want this far leftist to get into government. Zuckerberg himself and Facebook in general as a culture are leftists, maybe even far leftists. They violate your privacy, all kind of stuff. They do that, but even a guy like that and a company like that do not want Pocahontas to get into the presidency, because she is totally anti-big business, totally anti-corporations and big money, all that kind of stuff. At least on paper, she is. I mean, right now, she has this whole campaign about not accepting any kind of big money donations. I mean, Trump did the same thing when he first came out. The difference between her and Trump is that Trump was already basically a billionaire, if not a very high millionaire. Elizabeth Warren, I mean, I'm not really sure what kind of money she has. She raised like $12 million and small money donations in the second quarter of this year, but Trump's campaign and the RNC raised $100 million in that same period of time. After the impeachment inquiry was announced, Trump raised $15 million, okay, in a two-day period from mostly small donations in 2 days. So when you're talking about money, at a certain point, if you want to compete with the big dogs, you have to be able to take some kind of corporate money. That's just the reality of the situation, all right? Like I said, Trump said he was not going to take big money, but at a certain point, he had to. He took much less of it, obviously, than Hillary Clinton, much, much less, which gives him more autonomy to do what he pleases and to not be controlled and constrained. Pocahontas is going to understand that pretty soon, that you're going to have more money. Right now, she's not able to match Trump or the RNC at all. But for now, I digress. Let's get back to Zuck. Zuckerberg does not want her to be the president the same way many others in big money industries or big industries in general, CEO, executives, they don't want her to be the president. She is against big business, calling for wealth taxes and calling for things like she wants a company to be responsible for the pensions and stuff of a company that they acquire. You know, she is advocating for more and more regulations. That's not going to fly people like Zuckerberg, okay? Breaking up Facebook. Personally, I'm not a real big fan of Facebook, but at a certain point, you got to use it. They're everywhere. They're pervasive. Between Facebook, Instagram, and all the other properties that they own, you have to run into them at a certain point. You got to utilize them at a certain point, especially if you're in business and you advertising, you got to use them. People are there. It's the most populous place where people are at all over the world. You got to use it. Aside from me not being a big fan and understanding their importance, aside from that, I understand where Zuckerberg is coming from. He's like, okay, why break apart Facebook? What is that really going to do? I'm right there with him. What are you really going to accomplish by that? That's not the answer. If it were up to me, I would say enact more laws in the books for consumer privacy. I think Facebook got a $5 billion with a B dollar fine from the FTC because of privacy violations. If I'm wrong, let me know in the box. But I know there was a fine from them from that amount of money. The reason I may or may not be correct on. But privacy is obviously a big issue. Anytime you're dealing with an online entity with a lot of people on it, privacy is going to be a big concern. Breaking them up won't change that fact. Okay, it's just not. If it's the same company that everybody goes to, they log on to Facebook.com, breaking it up into little different groups, that it's just not going to change the underlying issue. Have more laws on privacy and the way that people's data is shared. Maybe you'd be able to have something happen that way. Aside from that, breaking them up is just to appease regular normies that are out there that don't really know about business too much. Getting back to people on Wall Street that don't like Elizabeth Warren, aka Pocahontas, they have said that if she becomes the president, they may just totally abstain from donating to her campaign or to anyone's campaign for that matter, or they may vote for Trump or they may support Trump. Okay, so rather than people that would normally donate to the Democratic Party, people that gave Hillary a lot of money to the tune of $1.3 billion with a B dollars in 2016's election, they'll take that money away from Elizabeth Warren and give it to Trump instead, or to nobody. And like I said earlier, she's not doing that well with the donations. She's doing okay, but it's not nearly enough to match Trump. And let's not forget, Trump won the 2016 election with half of the money Hillary Clinton was able to raise. How are you going to win the election with the incumbent president and less money? It doesn't make any sense. I'm glad that people like Elizabeth Warren are out here running. Bernie Sanders too. I feel like Warren and Sanders are the same person. You know, far leftist, communist, socialist, whatever. They're kind of the same person. You know, they're either enacting very large taxes or very restrictive regulations or a combination of both. You know, Bernie, big time tax. He'll tax anybody, regular normie. Warren is like trying to tax the big corporations. But ultimately, it's going to affect the regular everyday normie, because if you have the big corporations taxed, that's just going to be passed down to the regular consumer, the employee. They're not going to pay it. Okay, wealth taxes are just offshore money. It's not going to impact anyone except for the regular everyday American taxpayer working for a living. So shout out to Zuck for standing up for his company. Like I said, not a Facebook fan, but hey, I got to give credit where it's due. I think you'll see more guys like Zuck say things like this. Although it was not intended to be public, he did say it. Maybe some guys will come out publicly and say, hey, we're not going to support her. That's not going to be who we have as a president. And Warren did respond on Twitter, and I'll place that in the box and on the screen. Maybe she doesn't understand that a lot of American people, a lot of American taxpayers probably disagree with what she's saying. You know, some of the loudest voices on Twitter may be out there cheerleading and rah-rahing, pom-poms, all that kind of stuff for her. But that might not be the case for the entire country, and we're going to see that coming up if she is a front runner. Joe Biden's looking kind of bad right now, out here playing golf with the Burisma Holding guys and your son, talking about, oh, I never talked business with them, yet you on the golf course where you talk business, pretty much only. You don't even really play golf that much, but I digress. It does not look good for him. Warren is the runner-up candidate. She's already getting attacked. Who's going to be the candidate? Who's going to run? Whoever it is, you got to go right back to the center, because the far leftist people that you need to be in your corner are not feeling. But I think I'll leave that right there for now. And that's pretty much all I got. What say you? Do you think that Elizabeth Warren will get a nomination? If that's your viewpoint, let me know why in the comments below. If she does get the nomination, will she be supported by those that she needs support from? Big business, because she doesn't really have any money like that. How are you going to get donations? You can have small money donations, and that's fine. That's great. But how is that going to win an election? How are you going to even compete with the incumbent as a far leftist when the country's just trying to go right back to the center? How are you going to succeed like that? I want her to be the front runner, as well as Joe Biden or anybody else. To me, they're very easily defeated. The left and the right will be against them, to the point where people just won't go out there and vote, or they're going to support the current president, Trump, more than what they did before, or for the very first time, because they can't get along with what's going on the left. But whatever your comments are, please let me know in the comments below. And that's all I got to say for this video. If you like what you heard, please comment, rate, share, and subscribe. Peace.